What's up, everybody? My name is Sankus, and today we're gonna work on this drop a little bit. And in this video, we're gonna take some time and take that drop and turn it into this. So we're gonna do a few things in this video. First off, we're gonna do some EQing on some of these sounds just to try and bring them into balance a little bit. And this sound is a bit too crispy in my opinion and could use some toning down in some of these areas here in the middle. I'm also gonna use the limiter in compression mode so I can compress the sound a little bit more. Compression is pretty much the name of the game here. I'm also going to try and make a few changes to the patch itself. They're still pretty rough. It's good that we have all these sounds in here already, but they can definitely still use a little bit of tweaking to sound a little bit better. So one thing I'm going to do here to make this squelch a little bit cooler is I'm going to throw an LFO on the coarse pitch, and I'm going to do the same to the sine wave over here, which I'm going to bring down 2 octaves. And I'm going to create this cool little pitch modulation with this LFO here. So that definitely makes the squelch a lot cooler already. Adds that little bit of movement to the sound that it needed. Alright, cool beans. So, moving on to the next sound here. This little weird screechy thing can definitely be a lot better as well. I'm also gonna EQ it a little bit on the top here, take out some of those annoying frequencies. Try to tame some of the top here and still have some crispiness to it. And same as with the first sound, I'm gonna compress it a bit. And by a bit, I mean quite a bit. I'm also going to make some more tweaks to this patch as well, try and enhance it a little bit, maybe mess around with some of the filter in here, the FM, just try and get a little bit more interesting textures out of it, because right now it's a little bit of a ear sore, so I'm going to try and get something that's a little bit more interesting to listen to. So I'm gonna glue my drums together a little bit with this compressor here, like I did with the basses, except I'm gonna do it on the kick and the snare group. I'm just gonna use a bit of compression here and then try and get some gain out of them. So I might replace the kick later since I'm not really too happy with the sample choice there, which is definitely an important factor in the track. But for now, before I get too sidetracked with the drums, I'm gonna head on back to the bass and see what else I can do here. Now, going back to the basses, I'm gonna apply the same kind of pitch modulation to the sub bass here, the sine wave and the main wavetable with this second LFO. I'm gonna just create this pitch bend on both of these close fine pitches. And kinda like I did with the first growl bass, I'm gonna modulate the frequency here as well. Maybe you turn on the rate a little bit. All Cool, so I'm gonna move on to this last end growl thing here at the end. Pretty much the same thing, gonna start with some EQing. So now what I'm going to do is add some distortion and compression with Camel Crusher, which is a free plugin, and I'll add that to the bass group and kind of mesh them together a little bit. So I'm basically just looking for frequencies that kind of sound obnoxious to the ear that could be ducked a little bit. Some gnarly stuff going on. So I'm going to use OTT, which is another multiband compressor, kind of like Serum has the multiband compression mode. This kind of does the same thing. What I like to do usually during this process is load up Maximus and just solo the low band and listen to it soloed. Now I'm going to try and add this reversed snare kind of thing in front of the regular snare. And I'm basically just trying to create this whiplash sort of effect here. Alright, so now that we've tamed a little bit of that high end from the basses, I can start adding some in with these synth sounds and make them sound a little bit more present in the mix. Now I'll throw on good old Maximus here, and I'm gonna work on the frequency bands individually. My main goal here really is to get the sub bass, the bottom end of the bass group, to be nice and full and strong. So I want the low stuff, the low parts of the sub bass, the quieter parts, to come up while the louder parts are staying where they are. So you can see the green here representing what is being boosted, and it's boosting pretty much all the quiet stuff, and for the main part, leaving the louder stuff alone, still boosting and kind of flattening out a little bit. Of course, in dubstep, you know, you want a nice strong bottom end, so the stronger I can get that sub to sound, the more impactful this drop can feel. So for the purpose of just trying to fatten this drop out a little bit, right now this Maximus will do, but later on, once I start really trying to get into the nitty-gritty mixing, I might change this around a little bit and alter some of the releases of the compressors that are on, because we have a little bit of a tail going on from the compression, because there's a lot of compression going on. But as I said, for now, I think I'll keep it sort of like this. Doesn't sound that bad to me, actually. Can work with it. I still think that some of these sounds may need some work, so I'm gonna go to the second sound here and see what else I can do. Maybe put on this chorus and try and thicken it up a little bit. Maybe just mix it in a little bit. Don't want it to be too washed out. So going back to this preset here of the second sound, I think it could benefit from a little bit of a squarification. So I'm going to edit this wave table and squarify all of the wave shapes within this wave table. It already feels a lot cooler in my opinion, less messy and a bit more interesting to the ear, less aggravating to the ear. So I'll do the same here for this clone of this preset. So I still want to clean this sound up a little bit, this wobble, so I'm going to try and mess with the tension of this LFO here. And I'll probably pretty much do the same thing for this one here, even though I kind of like how it sounds. I might do this kind of thing for the second part of the drop, but for this particular sound, I'm also gonna decrease the tension a little bit. I'm gonna try and emphasize the snare a little bit by adding this cymbal on top of the snare. Gonna go ahead and clone this over, and just gonna copy and paste all of this, bring it over here, and then I can start making some changes to the second part. So to help transition into the second part here, I'm gonna create a new pattern. I'm gonna try and create a little bit of a riser with 3XOSC. An easy way to do that is by just pitching up a sine wave with a lot of reverb, and you got yourself a mini riser. So I can just use the slide function to pitch it up by a couple of octaves. Should probably make it a little bit longer. And of course it needs a little bit of EQing just in case. And some reverb. Some crazy amounts of reverb. So definitely need to try and clean up this transition here. There's a lot of release and reverb spilling into this second part here, so I'm just going to go to the riser that I just created. And I'm going to automate the mix of the reverb. So I can cut it out and just turn off the reverb right as the riser ends. So we don't have any like weird reverb spilling onto the next part. And it's not going to, you know, take away from that impact of the next part coming in. So the first bass hit, pretty much. I'm going to do the same for the reverb on T-Force Alpha Plus 2, just because that has a bit of release that spills over. So now I'm thinking I should probably try and come up with some cool chord ideas here at the end, because dubstep tends to have some of these little melodic fills at the end of their phrases. So I'm going to put in this new pattern here. I'm going to use a synth stab that I already have and just try and mess around with a few chords, see if anything that I come up with fits for this little transition. So I've got this chord progression here that might work. I'm just going to transpose some of these notes up a little bit. So I want these chords to feel a little bit more lush, so I'm going to copy the chord progression. I'm going to create another synth with 3XOSC. Basically just another super saw that's pretty detuned, and this one's just going to be layered with the other super saw. Alright, cool, so I'm just gonna copy these chords over. Gonna mess with the timing here a little bit. Just trying to figure out where I want them to start coming in. So maybe a little bit earlier here. So I want this last chord to have some tension, just trying to figure out the right chord to use for that. Alright, so I'm just going to send it to some sidechaining here. Alright, cool. So now to fill it up a little bit, I'm going to take the bottom notes from these chords here. Just going to copy them, and I'm going to insert them into another track with 3XOSC, and I'm going to build this kind of saw bass with some distortion on top of it and a little bit of white noise layered into it. Maybe transpose that D up a little bit. Now I'm gonna build a low pass filter with a EQ2 here. Just gonna low pass it and filter it in a little bit. So I'll automate this knob here. What I'll also do is automate the mix of the EQ, so this filter won't be active all the time, because you could lose some high end like that. So it didn't sound right, so I'm just gonna extend the bass and take away this saw bass while the growl bass is still playing so it doesn't interfere. I think it sounds a little bit smoother and flows a little bit better like that. But like I said, I'm gonna add some noise and now I'll link it, throw in some Camel Crusher here, and add a lot of distortion to it. I really want to distort the white noise and the saw together. And I'll use Vocodex to thicken it up a bit more. Now, of course, it's gonna need some EQing, so I'm gonna see what needs to be taken away here. Probably a lot of this 200Hz region here where the mud comes from. So I definitely think it's time to try and find a kick that works a little bit better here. So I'm gonna look for a kick that kind of I think would sound better in this mix. This one sounds a little bit too clicky to me. I want something that sounds a little bit less clicky than that. I'm gonna use one of these Starbucks samples here, I think. He has some pretty decent kicks in that pack. This one sounds a little bit thumpier and less clickier than the other one, so it's a little bit more than closer to what I wanted, so I think it'll sound a lot better with this one. Now a low end check here. So to make the bottom end feel cleaner and stronger, I'm gonna create a new sub bass in the next part. And that sub bass won't be going through the bass group, it will be linked in treat it a little bit differently than the rest of the basses, so hopefully that'll increase the power of this track and of the bottom end. So with that being said, thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a good one.